Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, we are continuing our React.js e-commerce series, and guys, we are at our shopping cart page. So guys, as we have seen that in previous video, we have fetched all our data of the cart table in our shopping cart page, guys. So now we are going to implement the quantity increment and decrement. Okay, so if we click on increment, it should increment and automatically increment the price, okay, according to its quantity. So let's get back to our React application. So guys, I'm on the cart page right now, and let's move below, and here is our increment and decrement button, guys. Let me just minimize this sidebar, and let's use on click event is equal to open and close. So before that, you need to create a function where you will tell handle decrement, open and close bracket, where we are going to tell item dot id. So we will pass that cart table's id, primary key. I'll show you over here this id, id 1 id 2. Okay, so this data we are going to pass. Perfect. So now same way, guys, we have to make this for the increment. Now guys, let's create a function for this handle decrement and increment. So let's move top. Let me just minimize this use effect, and before loading const handle increment, open close with arrow function, and here guys, we are going to get all the data. So first step, we have to get our increment value, I mean the cart item ID. So this ID you can get. Okay, so how will you get that? As cart underscore ID. So this will be a cart ID which we are getting from the decrement. And now guys, we are going to mess up with our set cart items. So inside this, we have the total value. So what value? Let me just refresh. Okay, so handle increment is not defined. Let's define it, guys. Let's copy and paste and just copy this and paste. That's it. So these datas are in our set cart state. Okay, so this is the set cart state. Inside this, we are taking and looping. So guys, we are going to mess with this data only while updating our quantity. So let's use this set cart function, semicolon, where we are going to take this cart arrow function. And now guys, inside this, we'll take again the cart and loop the data. So cart dot map function, where you'll tell item arrow function. And now guys, inside this, we are going to check the condition. So what condition? Your cart ID is triple equal to your item of ID. So item dot ID. Okay, if it is success, then you're going to print the code, else you will print the item itself. Okay, so this what it does means, we are going to loop like whatever we get the data. So this data, so right now we are having 2 and 3. So that data, guys, we will be updating it. So you can just give dot 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 item comma your product quantity. So what product quantity? Your cart table. So this is the column, product quantity, product underscore quantity colon, where inside your cart table, whatever we have fetched already, so that value item dot your product quantity. Okay, fetch data. So now we have to give minus, and let's give 1 over here. And now guys, same way, we are going to copy and paste for the increment also, and just make one change over here. Instead of minus, you have to give plus 1. Okay, so now guys, let's see the output. Okay, so once refresh, open your developer tool, move to console log. Perfect. So let's click on this two guys. So click 3, 4, it's going on. And now let's decrement to 1. Your price is also updating. You can see that. And it's going to 0. It's going to -1. So guys, let's make the code for like it should not go 0 or not below 0 guys, like -1, -2. So let's write the code for that also. Let's get back. And at this one, we have to set something like the quantity. Open and close bracket. Quantity is greater than 1. Give a ternary operator 1:0. Okay, let's remove this 1 from the last. So yep guys, so this is the code now which will handle the operation. And here we don't want to increment more than 10 guys, so let's make it to just 10 over here. And yep guys, so let's see the output. So now let's decrement guys, it's not going below. And let's increment, and it should not go more than 10 guys. Perfect. So how much ever, if you want to keep 50, 100, whatever, you can just give the condition over there. So guys, we have successfully done with this incrementing option in our cart page. Okay, so guys, when we are incrementing or decrementing the value, so these values should be updating in our database. So right now, as you can see that it's not updating. Okay, so here is 2 and we have set this to 4. So guys, we need to send some Axios data or request to update the data. So guys, now let's create a separate function with the name update quantity. So let's type function update quantity function, open and close curly brace. So guys, let's change this update quantity. Okay, so, I mean update cart quantity. And now let's send the Axios request. So guys, let's type Axios where dot with the put function we will update. Then so response of the data, and now let's send the API guys. So let's give /API, we will tell this as cart update quantity. Okay, where we will send the data, which is the cart _ID. And one more thing we are going to send, that is your increment or decrement data. So that will send as $OpenAndCloseCurlyBrace, where we will tell scope. Okay, so this scope, let's copy this cart ID, comma, and then your scope guys. So let's send over here. And now let's copy this function and call it into your handle decrement and increment guys. So let's send this over here, and in the place of scope, you are going to send the, this is decrement. So DEC, copy this and paste over here, and this is increment. So INC. Okay. And the cart ID you are getting from your increment function itself. Okay guys. So it's very clear now. So once this function is called increment or decrement, it will automatically call this cart update quantity. Now guys, let's move back to our cart update card function, and inside this let's write a if condition if you want to show the message. So response.data.status is triple equal to 200. If it is success, you are going to show a message using sweet alert, that is your swell function, where we'll tell success comma response.data.message comma, and your icon will be success guys. So let's save this. Now guys, let's copy this API and move to our Laravel application. Go to your api.php file and let's create a route guys. So we have to create a route using put method. Okay, so we are going to use put, where update quantity your cart _ID. Okay, so this ID you are getting from your route. So this cart ID, oops, we have given the wrong spelling, so make sure you have to give correct. So I have just missed that. Let's replace that from card to cart ID. All set, guys. So no confusion. Yep. Let's copy this cart ID. Let's get back and paste that cart ID / where scope we have to copy. The scope. Copy this. Get back. Scope. And move to your controller, guys. So let's move to our cart controller itself, where we will create a function name with update quantity. Okay. So let's copy and go back to our cart controller and create a function, guys. So let's type public function. Function name update quantity. And inside this, we are getting the cart ID and the scope. Okay. So let's get that cart_ID, $scope. Okay. So we got the both. And now guys, first step, we have to check our authentication. So guys, let's copy from the above. And this will give that 401 unauthorized if you are not logged in. Okay. Login to continue. And yep, guys. So once you get the data, you have to check the user ID. So authenticated user ID, you can just copy from there. And cart item is equal to your cart model, where :, give where condition. Again, where condition, we are going to check the user ID and then get the first record. Okay. So once the first record, we have to check only one. So guys, in this first where condition, we will check the cart ID. So this cart ID, copy and paste that cart ID. And in the second one, we are going to check the user ID. So let me just show you. This is your cart ID and this is the user ID. So yep, user_ID, where inside this you will take the user IDs over here, and done. User ID. Now guys, you are going to update the quantity. product_QTY is equal to your the increment or decrement value. How will you decide that? So we will be deciding using our scope, guys. So just use this $scope in a if condition. Let's type if $scope is double equal to your increment value, then what you will be doing as just cut this and you need to give +1. Okay, so if you want to increment, it will give +1, which will take the current value we are using first, guys. So this gets the data, and inside this, whatever, for example, the data is 3, then it will +1 with the 4. Okay, so this is how we are handling our increment and decrement in Laravel code, guys. So same way for if it is decrement, DEC. So this we are taking from our React application, guys, where you have set over here in the update function, update quantity, where decrement and increment, okay, that we are sending with this scope. Perfect. So let's get that DEC and from plus to minus, guys. So -1, whatever the value is there, just you need to minus it. And then guys, as usual, update the cart. So your cart item of update function. Then you can show the message, guys. So let's copy from here. Change the status to success, that is 200, and you will show that quantity updated. Okay. Save. Now is let's test. So let's get back to our React application. See once everything is perfect. So yep, let's get back refresh once, guys. Okay, so no error. Let's increment this to 4. Okay, 3. Quantity updated. This is showing a message. It's not looking good. So let's disable that. Okay, let's get back. I don't want to show the message on quantity increment or decrement. So let's just minimize it. Refresh it. You can see, guys, that we have incremented till 4 and it's coming 4. Let's increment to 6. Okay, and the cart quantity will be 6 over here. So this was the first product, right? So that first product is over here, and let's refresh. It's 6, guys. Perfect. So let's change this also from 3 to, I'll make it to 2, guys. So let me decrement, and it's done. Let's check in our database. Cool. So guys, we have successfully completed how to handle increment and decrement in our shopping cart page in React.js hooks. So guys, we have used React hooks to handle this quantity increment and decrement. So guys, let's continue in next video to show our total product of this, whatever the price is. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like, and share.